This man is on the spot tonight. Nairobi Governor Mike Sonko has clashed with the Office of the Auditor General over the payment of 98 million shillings to a company associated with Meru Senator Mithika Linturi. The senator, however, told the committee that he has never sought any contracts with the Nairobi City County. And as Stephen Leto now reports, the governor was hard-pressed to explain the millions spent on the beautification of Nairobi.
In an eight-hour grilling session, Nairobi Governor Mike Sonko's first submission was to discredit the report by the Auditor General that flagged outrageous expenses by Nairobi County during his first year in office.
Some of the responses were there on time. But Mr. Chair, this is a deal gone sour. Some of the queries were put there to make us pay the corruption fee that was asked by the auditors, and I'll prove.
In fact, his own words, he's preempted.
But if he really feels that his report is affected because of the corruption that has taken place, is something that we should not dismiss as a committee.
Sonko bravery claims that during the audit process prompted the committee to call for further investigations.
As I've said, there was a fee that was asked by my people and the auditors who has just seated. Me, I do not fear when I address issues pertaining to corruption. You are just seated here, Mr. Chair.
If you have issues against the Auditor General, let's deal with them in accordance with the Public Audit Act.
An agitated Meru Senator Mithika Linturi claimed that the audit report had listed his company, Gem CM Construction Limited, to have been paid a whopping 98.8 million shillings to rehabilitate Nduaru Road in Dagoretti South, money that Linturi says he has never received since his company has never applied for such a contract.
And when such a report makes me stand before the Senate and say money is being stolen, you can understand when there is erroneous reporting.
The tiff between Governor Sonko and Nairobi Senator Johnson Sakaja played out again, with Sonko tabling documents before the Moses Kajwang-led committee, accusing Nairobi Senator Sakaja of evading payments amounting to 40 million shillings.
The senator is tabling under a company known as Seven Star Media, and I wish to table the search of that company. He's a director himself with some other people. He's operating with a lot of impunity, putting billboards. He doesn't pay revenue. He's not declaring what he's putting up, cutting trees, removing our grass. That is affecting our revenue. That is affecting, because if he's doing business in Nairobi and he doesn't want to pay revenue,
point,
and then at the
order.
Same time, he says
order,
the revenue has declined.
Okay.
That is impunity of their share.
The governor was pressed to explain how 18 million shillings was spent on beautification of Nairobi.
So your submission is that the beautification pilot is fully funded by Governor Sonko?
Mr. Chair, it was a pilot project, but during this financial year, there is a budget for
it. Is
point,
you point, paid
of order, point of order, Mr. Chair.
Chairman, I'm on the floor. I've allowed the
Nairobi Governor Mike Sonko was supposed to attend a meeting with the same committee tomorrow, but that meeting has since been put off by the Senate Committee on Public Accounts and Investment Committee to attend to a special sitting by the Senate tomorrow to deliberate on the Division of Revenue Bill that puts the revenue share at 335 billion shillings and not 310 billion as proposed by Treasury. Stephen Leto, Citizen TV, Parliament Buildings, Nairobi.